Impulse generated at the SA node is carried by a special conductive system to throughout the heart. In this video, we will study that conductive system of the heart. Welcome back to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Let's get started. As we have already studied in a separate video, the SA node is a normal pacemaker of the heart and it generates impulses. Now this impulse spreads throughout the heart to trigger synchronized contraction of the atria and ventricles. There is a special conductive system to carry this impulse. It includes internodal and interatrial pathways, AV node, bundle of Hayes, right and left bundle branch, and Purkinje fibers. Now let's study each of them one by one. The ends of the sinus nodal fibers are connected directly to the surrounding atrial muscle fibers. Therefore, the action potential originated in the sinus node spreads directly into these atrial muscle fibers. The interatrial pathway passes through the anterior walls of the atria. It takes the impulse to the left atrium. So this is how impulse spreads to the atria. Then we have internodal pathways between SA node and AV node. It includes the anterior internodal pathway, middle internodal pathway, and posterior internodal pathway. They curve through the anterior, lateral, and posterior atrial walls respectively and terminate in the AV node. Obviously, they carry impulses from the SA node to the AV node. And this brings us to the AV node. The AV node is located in the posterior wall of the right atrium, immediately behind the tricuspid valve. It is the only site where the impulse can pass from the atria to the ventricles. This is because a continuous fibrous atrioventricular ring separates the atrial muscles from the ventricular muscles. It acts as an insulator and does not allow the passage of impulses from the atria to the ventricles. It also prevents re-entry of impulses from ventricles back into the atria. Thus, AV node is the only site where the impulse can pass from atria to the ventricles. Next point is that the delay in impulse conduction at the AV node allows time for the atria to empty their bloods into the ventricles. Let me explain what I mean. From the SA node, impulse spreads rapidly to all the muscle cells of both the atria and the AV node. Due to the incoming impulse, atrial muscles start contracting. However, the conduction of impulse through the AV node is so slow that the impulse does not reach the ventricles until the atria have contracted. So ventricles do not contract yet. Only after the completion of atrial contraction, impulse reaches the ventricles to trigger ventricular contraction. Thus, delay in the conduction in AV node allows time for atria to empty their blood into the ventricles. Without this delay, atria and ventricles would contract simultaneously and pumping would not be as efficient. Delay in the AV node prevents this. The cause of this slow conduction is less numbers of gap junctions in the AV nodal cells. So the resistance to conduction is more. That completes the AV node. Next we have the bundle of Hayes. It passes downwards in the ventricular septum towards the apex of the heart. Then the bundle divides into right and left bundle branches. Each bundle branch progressively divides into Purkinje fibers. Purkinje fibers are very large fibers. Transmission through them is so rapid that once the impulse enters the Purkinje system, it spreads almost immediately to the entire ventricular muscle mass. This speed is believed to be due to a high number of gap junctions between the cells of the Purkinje fibers. The fibers stimulate the ventricular muscles that are in direct vicinity. Spread to the remaining muscle cells occur by ventricular muscle cells themselves. Due to the fibrous ring, the impulse does not travel back into the atria. So this is the entire conductive system of the heart. Now let's see the sequence of depolarization in cardiac tissue. First, both the atria are depolarized. Then the septum is depolarized from left to right. then enteroseptal region of the myocardium towards the apex is depolarized. Then there is depolarization of the bulk of the ventricular myocardium from endocardium to the epicardium. Finally, the posterior portion of the base of the left ventricle is depolarized. If we mark the appearance of impulse at SA node at 0 second, all the atrial muscle cells are stimulated by 0.07 to 0.09 second. The impulse reaches to AV node at about 0.03 second and emerges at the other end at about 0.16 second. Finally, all the ventricular cells are activated by about 0.19 to 0.22 second. It is important to understand this course with exact timing to understand electrocardiogram. So this is the sequence of depolarization. Finally, let's see the velocity of impulse conduction in different parts of the conductive system. The speed of conduction in atrial muscle cells is about 0.3 meters per second. In atrial pathways, it's about 1 meter per second. Conduction in AV node is very slow, as we have already seen. The speed here is only 0.05 meters per second. In the bundle of His, the impulse travels at 1 meter per second. Purkinje fibers are the fastest, with a velocity of about 4 meters per second. In ventricular muscle cells, the impulse travels at 1 meter per second. So this is the conductive system of the heart. Very quick summary. The conductive system of the heart includes interatrial and internodal pathways, AV node, bundle of His, right and left bundle branches, and Purkinje fibers. Impulses are delayed at the AV node due to very slow conduction here. This allows atria to empty their blood into the ventricles before the ventricles contract. Purkinje fibers transmit impulses so rapidly that once the impulse enters the Purkinje system, it spreads almost immediately to the entire ventricular muscle mass. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe, because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.